Hey everyone, this is Juna with Detour Shirts here with another quick tip. In this quick tip, I'm going to talk about colors and how you can choose colors and how you can find colors. So this is a good example of colors. In Creative Market, they recently released the color of the season and they call it Velvet Jade. And you can see here, they listed all the different types of colors. And I'm going to talk about all of those as well as some other things that you can do in Affinity Designer. So first, let's talk about the things on the color palette. Let's look at these right here. This is the color palette in Affinity Designer. We have RGB, RGB Hex, HSL, CMYK, LAB, and Grayscale. So let's just talk RGB for a second. Let's start at the top. RGB is red, green, blue, and if you mix those together, you can make some pretty cool colors. And that's what this one is right here, RGB 9, 102, 96. So if you see that somewhere, you can just go to this RGB and type in those numbers, 9, 102, and 96. Enter, and you can see this color matches that color, the Velvet Jade, because we followed what they said here in RGB. So the next one, let's go RGB Hex. Now, this is similar to RGB, but we're using the hexadecimal, hex like hexagon six, six numbers, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And they relate to RGB right here. The first two are for R, the second two for G, and the last two for B. And with those numbers, the hexadecimal numbers, you can also create it. So if we copy this 096660, and hit enter, you can also see that makes the same kind of color. Now, if I went from hex to RGB, you can see it's the same color, right? So that's how we do it there. The next one, let's click on this, HSL. They don't do the HSL here, and I'm not going to talk too much about it, but let's just take a look at it. H is for hue, S is for saturation, L is for light. That's HSL. The next one is CMYK, which we use a lot. I like to use CMYK basically because everything that prints, like our t-shirts and mugs and posters, print in CMYK. That's the colors that they use to make prints. So right here is the CMYK colors. We can copy those. 89. You can do your numbers and then hit tab and then do the next number. 40, tab, 60, tab, 23, and hit enter. And you can see that's the CMYK version of Velvet Jade, and it looks, you know, almost spot on. So let's go through some of these other ones. LAB, LAB stands for light, and then A and B. They didn't pick any names for that. So basically your light, and then you can pick your different A and B spectrums. Not used a lot, but it's there if you happen to see LAB colors. And lastly, grayscale. Of course, grayscale isn't really that much color. It's just light white to black. But we do have this Pantone, and the way to find that Pantone color in Affinity Designer is a little bit different. You have to go to swatches. So when you go to swatches, click on this drop down and you'll see all the different colors. We're gonna use this Pantone Formula Guide Solid Coated. The C is for coated. And you can see all the colors right there. There's so many. So luckily there's this search bar and you type in 562. You don't have to type in C because we have the coded. And then hit enter and you see all of these have kind of a different color. They probably all have the 562 in it. Look for the one that kind of matches, which is this one right here. And if you go to color, you can see that is the right color, 562C right there. So those are the different ways that you can find color in Affinity Designer, especially if you're looking for these things. Have fun with this. Hopefully this helps you learn more about color. And the question of the day for this video is, have you used hexadecimal colors? Let me know in the comments below. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.